This episode of Tekzilla is sponsored by domain.com.
We got an email from Tom who writes in, I picked up on Shannon's notes on DEFCON and her comments about RFID. How about discussing this topic in particular? One, how can you tell if a credit or debit card has the chip on it? And two, can you test out various sleeves and wallets to see if they actually work? According to Consumer Reports, a lot of these devices are no better than aluminum foil. Thanks, Tom.
Don't knock the power of aluminum foil.
Oh, I'm not. Aluminum
Tom
foil does work. That's why you see a lot of people run around with RFID blocking wallets, and they just made it out of aluminum foil.
I mean, literally, this is aluminum foil. We wrapped it around my phone, and now you cannot call me.
Okay, let's see if it works, though. I want to see if this actually works. So I'm calling you right now, so it should transfer and start ringing. Okay, so that's my phone ringing. Do you hear anything?
No.
Is it vibrating at all?
No.
Your volume's up?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We just tested this before I rewrapped it with aluminum foil. It works. So it's kind of funny. So the cheapest, you know, if for some reason you're traveling in a foreign country and you're afraid they're going to walk out of, you know, customs in the foreign country and somebody's going to be blue snarfing, like, or blue snarfing. How old school can I get? If you think somebody's actually scanning RFID tags and you don't want to be scanned, you know, or
you
if you're
that.
Concerned about your credit cards with RFID tags being in them, you could wrap them in aluminum foil.
Yep.
This is a little less than fabulous looking.
It's not that fabulous looking, so if you do want to
but it works.
Pay for something a little bit more fashionable or something that looks a little bit more legit, say mm-hmm. if you work for a government contractor or something like that, there are a couple of options that I did pick up at DEFCON, so I wanted to run through those real quick. The first one is called the privacy case. So I picked up this one for about $75. It's basically just a simple metal case with a very, very hard gasket right here that mm-hmm. closes off any if in any buts, GPS signals, RFIDs, cell phone signals. It basically turns your phone into a brick while it's inside there.
That's pretty awesome.
And if you
want
to test it out, go ahead and stick your phone in there. What do you got in Nexus?
I got my Moto G.
Okay, so you got to close it nice and tight, make sure it's shut, and then I'll give you a call. Let it start ringing.
And such stylish colors.
And so stylish, I know, right? I got it laser etched.
I feel like we like beat this with a hammer.
So I'm ringing.
Okay, sounds like
you feel any vibrations? No calls?
No, we're not getting called here.
Okay, it works.
Very stylish, and you got something actually big
very
enough to
stylish.
Hold a passport too.
Yeah. So this last one is called the Black Hole of Death. No, not really. It's called the Black Hole Faraday Bag. So this one starts as little as $32. The one I picked up is $45, I believe, and they go all the way up to in the hundreds, depending on the laptop size that you want to fit in this case. But it pretty much is supposed to do the exact same thing. So we tested this not only with that, my phone, but also with a clipper card, definitely worked as well. So kind of interesting.
It's pretty crazy because it's essentially a wire mesh.
It's a wire mesh,
you
yeah.
Just kind of barely, that's actually wire
it's
mesh.
It's a mini Faraday cage for your phone.
And you fold it over.
Not so much on the weather resistant side for that one. You
right.
probably won't keep water out and things like that since it's just a little Velcro switch. But hey.
You can just see the screen glowing through the
You can
mesh.
See the screen glow. And they even have window options too on their website. So there's plenty of ones that you can purchase that way too if you want something that's a little bit more pretty. But yeah, they both work, which is pretty interesting. But of course, still aluminum foil is an option.
And if you're curious about whether or not there's an RFID tag in your credit card, look for sort of the Payless logo or one of these crazy brass
yes.
things in the front or whatever that metal is.
So you
is
see
there.
Those a lot in European credit cards.
Yeah.
Not so much in America, but I've started seeing them in increasing numbers.
The general consensus is that American credit card companies are being jerks by not implementing the RFID tag technology because it's going to help decrease the amount of fraud that's out there. I mean, it's interesting because we're looking at like a Visa card, a generic credit card, an American Express card. I think these are going to be everywhere in a couple of years.
I absolutely agree. Just this year I've gotten two of my credit cards replaced with the RFID versions of them. So I'm very, very happy about that
mm-hmm.
to personally because it is a little bit more secure.
We wait, ladies and gentlemen, with bated breath. You don't have to wait, though. There's more Tekzilla coming right up. But before we do that, let's take a moment to thank one of our sponsors.
When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you get the power to influence and control what people find when they search for you online. No other domain extensions tell your story with the same trust of a .com or a .net domain name. .com and .net domain extensions inject credibility into your online presence. And who doesn't want to be credible? We like domain.com because they're affordable, they're reliable, and they're easy to use. A .com domain is only $9.99 per year, and a .net is only $8.99 per year. Plus, the folks at domain.com gave Tekzilla an awesome offer for even more savings. Get 20% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code Tekzilla at checkout. That's 20% off, aka big time savings. Don't forget to use the coupon code Tekzilla. And when you think domain names, think domain.com.